So, it seems I was wrong and Lillia is not the gatekeeper. Anyway, Lillia's reveal trailer has been released and with it came a lot of speculation. To be released alongside her are the skins known as Spirit Blossom. These skins are inspired by the canon lore where a flower with the same name exists, and are not the first skins to be released based on lore. I say based as there are skins which are canon and not just inspired by the lore. For example, Freljord Silas. But this is the first time that we see non-canon skins being present in what we assume is a canon video. The new skins are Spirit Blossom Lillia, Thresh, Vayne, Teemo, along with the Prestige version, and Yasuo. Some cool easter eggs are Thresh's lantern in Teemo's splash art,
and Yasuo's reflection,
displaying a different sword and maybe a different person. Yes, maybe it's Yone. In Lillia's reveal trailer, we see the Teemo skin, we can also hear his laugh, we can see a frog, which might be linked to the Nexus Blitz map. We also see the masks of the Taker, see the wicked eyes and horns. There's also a fox mask, probably a reference to the Gatekeeper. Both the Taker and the Gatekeeper are mentioned in the story Perennial, where the Blossom Festival and the Spirit Blossoms were first mentioned. And then a person who resembles Riven appears. You can also see her broken blade, with a mysterious figure behind her, almost reminiscent of the Blood Moon skins. This may be a Riven skin, as we also see Teemo's skin in this video. The figure behind her might or might not be related to the next champion. And in the end, we see the Blossom Festival. Lillia talks about a mother tree. She says that the mother tree is dying and that this is the motivation for her leaving the garden, where she lives. In her bio, we learn more about this tree, but there is one forest, hidden away, that draws on a different kind of magic. A garden with a tree at its heart, that gathers humanity's dreams in its blooms. The dreaming tree grew from a seed of the God-Willow, which towered over the ancient grove of Omikayalan, cast loose when the God-Willow was tragically felled. The seed took root in what came to be known as the Garden of Forgetting, nurtured by the Green Father, Ivern. As many of the descendants of Omikayalan were, the dreaming tree spiraled up, spreading the magic of humanity's desires each time the dream-laden buds bloom. So I was right about there being a connection between this tree and the Godwill. The Garden of Forgetting is not only the name of one of Ahri's stories, but also the main setting of said story. She had heard legends of the sacred grove since childhood, but had never before traversed the southern caverns to find it. According to the stories, those who stepped over the threshold of the garden began as one person and left as someone else entirely, or did not leave at all. In this story, Ahri comes to this place to get rid of the memories of the one she loved, that she killed by sucking the dreams and memories out of him. There's a flower who would make her forget her memories by absorbing them. So we know that in Omikayalan, also known as the Heart of the World, also known as Green Glade, lived the God Willow, from which a seed fell when Ivern cut the tree down. The seed then took root in what is now known as the Garden of Forgetting. I also want to mention that Ahri was supposedly the lady with golden eyes, wearing a gatekeeper mask in the story Perennial. Lillia's bio also mentions the Noxian invasion, possibly explaining the clips theorized in my previous video. It is either the Noxus invasion or any other battle between the various factions of Ionia, such as the Order of Shadow, the Navari Brotherhood, Aurelia's followers, or even the various Vestaya, as I will mention when I talk about the new Xayah and Rakan story. There's also the mention of a lone figure running away from warriors. Lillia uses her magic to put them all to sleep, but not before one of the warriors cut a branch of the tree that contained Lillia's unrealized dream, which I interpreted as being protecting the mother tree. However, a dream emerged from the lone figure, but as the warrior slept and Lillia wept, a dream emerged from the lone figure the others had been chasing. Weakly, it floated toward the broken branch on the ground and moved it to the bot's butt. Lillia picked it up. She could feel the dream as she whispered to it and soothed it. It glowed ever brighter, and so did she. The bud upon her head unfurled, a magic swirled around like sparkling pollen. At that moment, swept up in possibility and wonder, Lillia herself bloomed until, with a sneeze, she sent the magic curling into the surrounding forest. This is the origin story of Lillia's staff. Who this lone figure is, we never learned in the story. But scrolling down and seeing the related champions, there's Lillia, obviously, there's Ivern, who is mentioned in the story, there's Ahri, since the Garden of Forgetting is mentioned, but there's also Yasuo, which leads me to conclude that he is the lone figure. I think this theory might get confirmed as soon as we get Lillia's interactions in-game. We also got a new Xayah and Rakan story, which I assume depicts the events from the cinematic Wild Magic. Here's a side-by-side comparison between the story and the cinematic. Thank you. Xayah and Rakan seek to destroy these rocks, which we now know are called Quinlan, to release its magic to the world. In the story, there's a mention of a mage holding a hornet brass bell, which misted a dark vapor, a magically touched bell. Xayah and Rakan are trying to infiltrate into a city, and this mage is guarding it, using its magic to find Vestaya and Yordle intruders. I think the mention of a bell is quite interesting, as this bell also appears in the art of the story. If you remember, bells were mentioned in the perennial story too, and I wonder if there's any connection. Perhaps there's a relation between the shadow magic used by Zed's order and the new champion. Another interesting fact is that the voice mentioned that someone took Lillia's home, which is a theme from the new Xayah and Rakan story, humans taking the home that once belonged to Vestaya. I want to point out that Zed is not in this story's related champions, despite most likely being part of it, while on Lillia's Bayou, Yasuo was present without being much implied to be part of the story. I think it's just a weird thing. With this being said, I'll see you guys in the next video.